And it's time now to turn our focus to our big story this hour, the NewsX Business World panels on the Indian economy. As always, a special panel joins us to decode the current state of the Indian economy, look ahead at what lies ahead for India, what the government needs to do, how tough this past year has been, how much the budget has managed to help things around. Well, joining us at this point is Abneet Singh Marwa, Director and CEO, Super Plastronics Private Limited. We also have Jitin Sharma, Founder and MD, Okinawa Technology, joining us live. Satyajit Pradhan, co-founder and CEO, BusyDale Nets is joining us live. Ankit Dudhwewala, founder, CalHippo, and SoftwareSuggest.com is also joining the broadcast. Dr. Anurag Batra, chairman, Business World, is live with us as well. Welcome all of you and thank you for being with us today. Abneet Singh Marwa, let me begin with you first. How tough has this year really been for you and your business? Let's begin with that before we, of course, look at some other big questions.
I think 2020 was a year that everybody wants to forget now, and there's a new beginning in 2021. It's a great learning, to be honest, for our organization, because nothing was planned, and when nothing is planned, you will learn in a way better manner, and that's what we did. Yes, there were a lot of challenges, both in terms of sales and in terms of demand. I think that is a common phenomena that has happened in 2020. In terms of manufacturing, I think it's blessing in disguise that due to the pandemic, I think the one word that our PM mentioned was Atmanirbhar.
Yes.
From last 10 years, I think I've been very vocal about it, that India needs to create its own ecosystem. We never had our own ecosystem. We were completely dependent in terms of, if I talk about consumer electronics. And now we have realized that in 2021, I think we need to now extend that value addition of ecosystem.
Okay. Abneet, as far as the financial stimulus packages were concerned last year and the union budget of this year, how much have they actually aided you? How much have they helped your sector?
I think I've said that, I've mentioned that there has not been much of aid that government has provided to MSMEs, and in terms of, yes, there have been a lot of policies in terms of how to grow your manufacturing sectors. There has been a lot of new policies and new benefits that government is now providing. So I think in a holistic picture, if I tell you that they are going on the right direction, it's just that it's turned off the economy, how it behaves, how the demand reacts in 2021, that's a very important question right now.
Okay. Abneet, in terms of what's really changed in your working style, your company's working style, what's something that's changed perhaps for the better in this last year?
I think for any company, it's been work from home, saving a lot of lease amount for the organization. And I think from work from home, what I feel that there has been more output, and how we are connected in terms of my team, and because we see a lot of marketing and sales, mm-hmm. lot of traveling was there. I think we haven't dropped our revenue, and still without going one single, the whole year didn't went anywhere, and still we never dropped any revenue. So it's a big learning that you can save more time and you can connect easily through all the applications that you have available.
Okay, Mr. Pradhan, let me quickly rope you in here. Tell us a bit about what your business does and how tough the last year has been for you.
Well, I'm mostly into digital and technology business. Last year have been slightly a hit because most of our businesses are mostly in from European and US market. And compared to the last year, it has been, for the IT, it has been the most prominent internal function in the aftermath of COVID-19, with business and other functions expecting IT services and support like never before. IT will, after this COVID-19, IT will definitely become the backbone of the business. Yes, we had received many of our clients' requests, and sales have been good last year because of the industry is going into the digital transformations, and they're depending more on the IT infrastructure. So we did well, and there was we didn't decline in our revenue. We had a good revenue last year.
Okay. And what about, you know, Mr. Pradhan, the budget, you know, the union budget of this year, also the financial stimulus packages announced last year by the government, RBI also came up with certain measures. How much has that helped ease the burden? How beneficial was that for your sector?
Well, like I said, the union budget of 2021 was not like similar to the previous ones, and because this budget was mostly into focused on the Atmanirbhar Bharat, which is quite extraordinary and enthusiastic. And being from the IT industry, we were like this was quite encouraging for us. This budget, gave us like the hope of building up the soft technology right in here itself. It has given up the. It has asked us to become self-reliant and self-sustained, basically. And apart from that, this the budget was also the focus of the digitization of the economy. And that's and like I said, the IT industries had been struggling since last 1 year due to the pandemic. But this the budget has helped the the IT industry. Helped the IT industries in terms of going into digitizations and helping the business into digital transformations. So this has helped a lot.
Okay, let me take that across to Ankit at this point. Okay, before Ankit, let me ask Mr. Pradhan the same question I asked to Avneet before we move over to Ankit. For your business, for your working style, what has changed for the better?
Well, we have, definitely the work from home culture. Earlier, we were mostly into the, in the office culture, going to the office, working there till late nights. But this pandemic brought in the working home culture. The productivity has increased, and also the bonding between the team has increased because obviously they were earlier. We have a lot of interactions now and then, caring for the people, caring for the team. Because we don't see physically each other, but yes, we definitely ensure that. In the day we have meet and greet each other, say hello to each other, and that's how the pandemic has brought us together more.
Okay. Ankit, Dudhwala, let me take that across to you. For your business, how tough was the last year, your businesses rather, because you're representing two today. Tell us a bit about what they do, how this last year has really panned out, what were some of the steps you took to mitigate, the impact of the pandemic.
Sure. So I run two businesses. One is Software Service, which is a software and IT service discovery network and recommendation platform. And the other thing which we run is a telephony system, which helps call centers across the globe support their customers. With respect to our business, I think, the last year was tricky for our business. It was not as bad as we thought it is last week. So when the pandemic hit in mid-March when the pandemic hit India. And initially we were pretty scared that it is not going to go well and our revenues might take a dip. But eventually, we have almost grown about 100% in the last 1 year. What we have realized is that the pandemic led to businesses adopting technology and softwares, and that has actually helped us grow as an organization. So overall it was pretty decent for us, and as everyone mentioned, we also moved into work from home. We realized the benefit of work from home. We realized that work from home could help us reduce cost, and we also realized that with work from home we can hire team members from across the globe. So overall it has been pretty decent for us. The Indian economy has suffered. We are also not very happy with the pandemic, but I cannot say that we'll be complaining about the pandemic. Coming to the second part, with respect to the budget, I think this budget has been phenomenal. The government has paid a lot of respect or paid a lot of importance on infrastructure development. A lot of money and spending is going into infrastructure development, and all of us understand that if any government spends on infrastructure, both software company and the other companies in the country are going to grow. So overall, I think that the government has done a phenomenal job with this budget.
Okay. Let me also, in fact, bring in your opinion on the not just the budget, of course, but the stimulus measures. How much has that actually helped your sector? What more though still needs to be done, according to you, if we expand that a bit?
So I think there are some things which are very obvious, like the government delaying EMI and principal payment, and then the very obvious things where they're giving government back loans at low interest rates. But what I think was most important is that the Indian government decided not to print currency to come over Corona like the other government, which has helped ensure that rupee does not get depreciated and which has benefited both exporters and importers.
Okay.
Even now the RBI has been buying currency and trying to make buying dollars and trying to ensure that that dollar is at around 72-73, and I think that is one of the best things which the Indian government is doing from its end, from the stimulus point of view.
Okay, let me take that in fact across to Jiten Sharma as well. Jiten Sharma, come in here on the last year for you. For your business, how have things been? Has it been tough for you? What were some of the measures and steps you took perhaps to mitigate the impact, some new trends that have emerged for your business and your sector? Jitendra Sharma, are you able to hear me, sir?
Yeah.
That's for
okay,
you.
Okay, yeah, coming to your first point, like about the union budget, I'll talk about that. I think this budget 21-22 is effectively set the roadmap for the next 5 years with a slow measure to overall economic growth. The best part of this budget is it depends on focus for Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India. Because especially for the automobile industry, they increase the custom duty or the automobile parts, which encourages the domestic manufacturing. So in fact, it will boost the overall Make in India concept for the Indian economy. And apart from this, they already have capex of 1.08 trillion for the Ministry of Road Transport. It means they are strengthening the infrastructure of the country, which will bring the growth to the country and for the people of India. And apart from this, the commitment for the 1.97 lakh crores of PLI scheme for the trucking sector, that is a very good scheme for the, especially for the entrepreneur, for the business, the new startup, the new company which are coming in to get the benefit from this PLI scheme, so that the more and more Indian company will promote their businesses in India and they will bring a good supply chain base for overall industry. Apart from this, of course, for as a EV play, EV manufacturer, I think we look at reducing the GST and reconsidering the current taxation framework for this, so that because as of today for the EV there is a limited GST structure and the cash flow will stuck there. So I think government will look after it, the whatever the parts we are buying at the same duty structure, the final product is sold to the end user. I think overall, if you see, this is a very good budget for the growth perspective, and we are geared up for the same for that. And the next question, how the business impacted by the COVID. Of course, this pandemic is not good for anyone, and it affects the auto industry in a very big way in the initial phase. There has been a significant impact on everybody, including logistics, supply chain, manufacturing, even the manforce for the manufacturing industries. But once the lockdown was over, all the stakeholders of Okinawa, we set and gauged the overall impact of the businesses so that we can do the most best product to give to our consumer. The most effective component during for the EV during this pandemic was the lithium-ion cells, because these cells come from outside India. And that was the only bottleneck during those period. But fortunately, we were geared up with all these things, and it will not affect our business because we already have a lineup of a good supply chain in India, that we have a localization factor of more than 92%. We are using our EV, and very soon in the next quarter, it will be 100% localization made in India, other than the lithium-ion cells. So we are geared up for this. Of course, this pandemic, we have lots of challenges, which we try to convert that challenges into opportunity to bring a good thing for our industry, for our people, for our manpower, and give a good quality product to our consumer.
Okay. And Jitendra, as far as of course some new trends are concerned, What are some new trends that you believe have emerged over the last year in your group, in your sector?
I think one is that this is a problem solving trend. People are more connected on the virtually, because especially in our sector where we are working not from remotely, because we have a manufacturing setup, we have a dealer network in India, where the customer has to come to the dealership to check the product, do the riding of the product, and which it suits to them, then they will buy this product. But during the pandemic, of course, Okinawa, we have taken this as a challenge, and we have converted our e-commerce website, we have launched that so that our consumer can buy this product online. And our dealers has given a very fantastic job. They are giving the test ride to the consumer at their doorstep. Once they finalize it, they give the delivery to the consumer. And I think this concept is not by automobile industry. I think most of the industries have adopted this type of strategy during the pandemic. And I think it is going to be a healthier, you can say, decision for them as a business point of view. So that this future is going to be more futuristic things, because more online things are happening in now and for the future. I think more digitization of India economy is going to happen for the overall industry.
Okay. Let me, in fact, at this point, take a very short break. After the break, we'll open it up to some larger questions as well. Stay with us. Welcome back from the break. You're watching NewsX. We are, of course, currently discussing on the special NewsX Business World panels on the Indian economy, the current state of the economy, and also, of course, some bigger questions. Let me go across back to Jitin Sharma, whom we were, of course, speaking to before we took this break. Jitin Sharma, as far as your working style is concerned, what's something that's changed for the better for your group?
I think we are connected a lot with as a team, as a stakeholder, because not only Okinawa people, whether it's a supplier, it's a dealer, or it's a customer. So we are well connected through virtual connection during this lockdown, and we learn a lot of things as this teaches, the pandemic that teaches a lot of things. So of course, all the stakeholders understand these challenges of this pandemic, and we have converted into opportunity in terms of increasing the digitization of our business. Like we have done lots of ATL activity for the marketing to utilize the digital space to the best. As we always, as Okinawa, the company is also working on strengthening the dealership network and the post-sales service. So as a background, work done in the direction would enable us to perform the better as market improves and return to the normalcy. Like even we have given the service on wheels to our consumer, because in the automobile industry, service is very important part of that. So we have given the service on wheels to the consumer at their doorstep. If they need it, our dealers, our engineers do visit at their doorstep and give the services at their end. So like lots of handshake between all the stakeholders has teachers during this pandemic. And of course, this is a very good thing to understand how we can cater our last customer, how to take care of their needs and give the best outcome from all these things.
Okay. And also, of course, you know, I have to now ask some larger questions as well on the last year's lessons for all of you. Satyajit Pradhan, what's been a big lockdown learning, a big lockdown lesson for you in this last year?
Well, the biggest learning that as a company we have received is, yes, it's not only about the work, it's also about the relations that we share as a team, the bonding that we share, and that will eventually lead to business. Mm-hmm. So that is the biggest learning that we have received. Coming to as an individual, I think my personal bonding with the family and has increased, because earlier I was occupied with either the work or the amount of time that I used to give earlier was slightly lesser than that I started giving in after the pandemic, and same with the team as well.
Okay. Your lockdown learning, Ankit, your lockdown lesson from last year?
Yeah, so I think the most important lesson for us has been around productivity. So what happened before Corona was, we were working from the same office and we could see each other working. So someone who comes at 9 a.m. in the morning and goes at 9 p.m. in the evening, for us, it was like the person is hardworking and the person is productive. But when Corona happened, we had to start work from home, and then we were not seeing each other working. And that is when we realized that our method of measuring productivity was wrong, it was incorrect. So the most important lesson has been around productivity. Now we don't measure productivity as to the number of hours a person is giving in. What we try to do is we try to measure productivity around how effective those hours have been. We have OKRs and we have systems and processes in place which does not make time important, but effectiveness more important. And I think that has been the most important change in the organization. That has been the most important learning for the organization.
Okay. Avneet, Marwa, your lockdown lesson of last year?
I think my biggest learning was not to take things grantedly. I think this break has certainly given us a lot of time in terms of how to, what are the market trends. Normally, you were developing products where, what was there in the market trends. And you were just following the market trends. I think the biggest learning for us is if you have innovation, if you have R&D in-house, I think you can develop something for market, and that's what we did. We developed many new products. In fact, we were the first Android licensee for India. Kodak was one of the first TV manufacturing brand, and that too we were not dependent. So this is one of our learning. And then yes, how to balance your life. I think the most important thing was because the working hours were such that we were just completely inclined towards working. I think what has this pandemic has taught us how to balance your work life versus your family time and a peace of mind. And as I told you that you will hear this from most of the guys, that without dropping their current turnovers, revenues, they have still managed to balance their time and they have seen growth as well. So, always there is back of mind that you're not able to give a lot of time on your other things, but this is a very, very big lesson, and that's where now we have started balancing, and I always tell our employees also how to balance your life.
Okay. Jitin Sharma, your lockdown learnings, your lockdown lessons of the last year?
Yes, of course. I think every entrepreneur or a human being has an interesting journey filled with the learning. And I think it is important to share, learn from each other and contribute to the ecosystem at large. Like COVID-19 has changed my world and the entire people world also. But it's something all the humanity is going through together. So I think there are three things which I learned during this pandemic. One is, nothing ever remains the same. Means change is a constant and everything has to be changed accordingly. One of the most valuable lessons which I learned was the fact that nothing will remain the same, whether that is because of the pandemic or just nothing stay the same. I have been so impressed and moved by a simple act of kindness which I have seen from my friends, my staff, my organization people, all the stakeholders of Okinawa and even stranger on the internet. When you focus on the good, I think the good gets more better. So this is the one thing. Second, the safety of my employees is the most important for me, which I learned during this. So like biggest lesson which I learned is to invest in the safety of my employees. So I've seen how we have to do the contingency plan with regard to the welfare of our staff, our manpower and other related stakeholders. Third thing and the most important thing is like mental and physical health. War and is wealth. Means the mental health is very for every human being who are tested to the maximum originality, creativity and initiative. The three things the most entrepreneurs are known for and were put on the test during this pandemic time. So it was daunting tasks balancing between business orders on a fulcrum of instability. So I think this makes everybody aware about that. Their mental and the physical health is at the end of the day is the wealth for them. So I think we should always focus on that two things.
Okay. as far as now the recovery is concerned, you know, how far are we from the recovery, in your opinion, Ankit? Let me begin with you first. You know, how are we 3 months away, 6 months away, 1 year away from the economy to return to pre-COVID levels? What's your expectation? What's your assessment of where things stand right now and why?
I don't think we are more than 3 months away from the recovery. If you look at the quarter three numbers of most companies which have come out, so most of these numbers have been positive. India is almost seeing a V-shaped recovery, and the Indian government has also been able to control corona at our end. This coupled with the vaccination drive of the Indian government, which went into the second phase today, I think in the next 30 to 60 days, most Indians who need to be vaccinated will be vaccinated, and that is actually going to help us in major growth in the coming days. I also think that a lot of companies are trying to move out of China. They don't want to have a single base of manufacturing in China. They are looking for other opportunities and other countries to have their manufacturing base, and that again I think is going to help India in the next few months.
Okay. Satyajit Pradhan, your assessment of where things stand right now, how far are we from a recovery, complete recovery? When can the economy return to pre-COVID levels and why?
Like Ankit said, that we are just 3 to 4 months away from the recovering to the normal state, and the Indian economy is limping back to the normal as of now, and the quarter three reports of most of the companies have been positive. Mm-hmm. Also, we are, based on those reports, we are out of the technical recession, that I can say. And so over the period of time, and as the economy recovers, the market will also be up. So we are just 90 to 120 days away from that.
Okay. Jitin Sharma?
I think in my opinion, what these two gentlemen said, maybe rightly said, but if you see the overall growth of the economy of India is not related to only the particular industry, whether it's EV industry as a manufacturer of EV, two-wheeler, Okinawa, or maybe for all the industry. I think it will take some time, maybe 6 months or 12 years. There is a logic behind that, because as a part of economy growth and the degrowth, it all depends upon all the stakeholders, like as a person who are related to that. And I think we should be optimistic for that, because what we are doing today, that is going to happen for the tomorrow, and that is going to be the future for that. I think one of the two schemes which you already discussed earlier, like whether it's Atmanirbhar Bharat or maybe the PLI scheme, because it will boost the entrepreneur and the new startup which is coming in after this PLI. And just to start this new PLI for the new startup, it will take some time to grow for that. So I think this economy will take some time to make in India, Atmanirbhar Bharat, or to get the self-reliant India. So growth will be slow, but it will be steady and will permanent feature for the economic growth for India. So I think it is going to be happening another 6 to 12 months, but it will be a permanent feature for India.
Okay, it's going to be a permanent feature for India is what you're saying. Agnit Marwa, same question to you. How far are we from the recovery, complete recovery? What's your assessment of where things stand right now and why?
I think the complete recovery will take little more time than expected. One of the biggest relief is that the GDP is in positive right now. But other than that, 2020 was where there was a lockdown and suddenly there was a pent-up demand. Some pent-up demand was, as soon as the markets got opened, and some was when the cash flow situation was better in India. But 2021 will be a very stunning year. Most of the raw material components across the globe are getting really expensive. And India is a very price-sensitive market. If I talk about consumer electronic itself, most of the raw material is becoming is about up by 100-300%, and as soon as the prices go up, demand slow down in India. So this is a very big challenge. How government will tackle with this problem, because we don't have an ecosystem. Most of the raw material components are non-manufactured in India. And in 2021, I think we'll be recovering. I think 2022 will be a year where we will be fully recovered.
Okay. You know, as far as now the situation is concerned on the new trends that have emerged, it's been an unprecedented year, which has given birth to some new trends, some new sentiment amongst consumers, new business models as well. What are those, in your opinion, that you have observed? Avneet, let me begin with you.
Yeah, for us, Kodak is a smart TV brand. And the biggest trend that we saw was whatever we were expecting in next 3 years, I think in six months we had to deliver. One of the biggest things was OTT. As local production got stopped and most of the, you know, daily soaps were not being telecasted, so the OTT platform played a very vital role. People now shifted from normal D2H to OTT platforms. There was a huge spike, and this is now the new Indian trend where all the new generation, and in fact we've seen a huge spike above 45 age group as well. So the new trend will be that we'll be new experiments on OTT platform. We have just launched Android TV with Duo, where you don't need your phone. You can arrange your meetings on a larger screen. Then another new trend is AI. We all our televisions have Google Assistant. So people are now very interactive with the television. And one of the best part is you don't have to type. So just with voice command, and the consumers are giving very good response for all these new technology. So I would say the trend is now going towards completely on technology. Next 5 years will be a complete disruption of technology. And AI will play a very vital role. The best part is that most of the components, the hardware remains the same. And as India, we have a strength of software. So there is a huge opportunity. We can serve into a domestic market as well as we can do a lot of exports of software.
Okay. Let me take that across to Jitendra Sharma. Jitendra, what are the trends that you have observed, new trends that have observed that you have observed that are here to stay, that came up last year, consumer sentiment, how has it changed for you? Has the business model also changed? Has your way of marketing changed? What are some of the changes, some of the new trends?
Okay, if you see in the automobile industry, especially in the EV segment, the most important thing is people are more toward the environment conscious about that. During this pandemic, everybody has seen that. Even during this pandemic, the lockdown, we have seen that clean sky also.
Yeah.
So people understand what is the importance of the environment, how we can stop the global warming about that. Because lots of things, these natural calamities we have seen recently passed also. And in fact, there is one article comes last week in the Times of India also, 54,000 people have died because of the pollution only in Delhi last year. So I think we should be cautious about, as a stakeholder for the society, that of course in the automobile industry, EV is a small thing which is contributing factor for the pollution. So, but we have to start from somewhere. So I think now the people are moving towards IC engine to the electric vehicles, because in the electric vehicle there is lots of things like even artificial intelligence. The scooter can be controlled through your smartphone. So these are technologies already available in electric vehicles, and now the most of the performance vehicle is already there. So like in the Okinawa, on the high speed vehicles, lots of, you can say, artificial intelligence features already available in the vehicles. So people will go for it. And recently, like B2B segment, because at the end of the day, cost is running hot. As India is a cost sensitive market, especially for B2B players. Every buy of their tool, then they go from delivery boys for leave the food delivery boys. The cost of delivering is also a very important part of that. But in case of EV, the cost is almost 1/10 of what we are paying for the IC engine. So B2B segment is also going to be a very big for the EV vehicle. And in fact, for the B2C segment, I think lots of good product is available. So people are going for the electric vehicles for two reasons. One, of course, for environment. Second, of course, for the economics benefit, because the running cost is very less. And in fact, after BS6, the capital cost of the product is almost equal to the IC engine of the two-wheeler. So this is the best thing for the consumer to go for EV, so that they will contribute something for their tomorrow, for their future generation also. and get the good for their pocket also. So EV is going to be the next trend for the automobile industry, and I think that disruption is already started, is already happened. So electrification of this industry of automobile industry is already started, and nobody can stop it. So this is going to be the future.
Okay, let me also in fact quickly bring in Ankit at this point. Ankit, your new trends that you have seen emerge over the last 1 year, what's something new that you've emerged, what's changed in consumer sentiment and perhaps your way of running your business as well?
So I think work from home is something which is going to stay, and I'll tell you why. Because imagine a person who is living in a small town in Bihar. He travels all the way to Bangalore just to find job and pays most of his income in rents and the cost of traveling to and cost of traveling. Now what happens with work from home is this guy can still stay in his own hometown in Bihar. He can work for the same company and he can make the same earnings sitting in his hometown for the company, for the organization. On the other hand, the organization also rents out space for this person. They give them air conditioning, they give them chair, table, food. There is a lot of cost advantage even for the software company. So I think in the longer run, work from home is going to stay. There are companies like Infosys and TCS who have gone ahead and said that 20-25% of their workforce is going to be in work from home always. And I think this is going to be one very important trend which will come out of the corona crisis.
Okay, Satyajit Pradhan, what have you observed? Amongst new trends, new working trends, new buying trends, new trends from the sides of consumers. What's the sentiment like right now? What have you observed?
Well, there are three things I would like to say here. First is digital transformation. The business is going to digital transformation now because of the pandemic. Most of the businesses bringing in their experiences, product experience and sales to customers' home. That would be the second point. And the third would be, like Ankit said, is work from home. These are the three trends. I've been into the AR, VR and AI industry. I have seen the clients, many clients coming up for the digital transformation or depending on the AI and AR, VR part for digital interactions. And this has been increasing since past 1 year. And this is going to stay, people have now realized the importance of digital world, and digital India is helping the boost to such mission.
Yeah.
And I think this is gonna stay. The digital transformation is gonna stay for a long.
Okay. Last quick question, your closing comments and of course also any expectations that you have from government, anything that you hope they would do that would greatly help your sector and your work. Let me begin with Satyajit Pradhan once again.
Well, I would expect a little bit of more credit part from the government in terms of to the startups, to the and also more reforms and taxation reforms and also structural reforms to the startups where they can, which are majorly affected, and like the ITs or the other startups. Those things can help them boost and recover from the crisis of the pandemic. I think that would be much better.
Okay. Let me also quickly, bring in Ankit at this point for his perspective before we close. Ankit, your closing comment?
Yeah, so I think the government of India is already doing a lot. So the fact that our finance minister did not have the old briefcase but had a tablet in her hand for the budget was in itself showing that the government is looking forward and they want to modify themselves and they want to grow. But that said, as I said, a lot of companies want to move out of China and set up manufacturing in other countries like India, Indonesia. If the government can get in some benefits, put in some schemes and try and attract these companies to come to the country, it can help the economy grow faster.
Okay. Jitin Sharma, your closing comment?
Sure. Of course, like in the EV industry, like with lots of electric revolution going to happen, and I think it's get breakthrough like different initiative like Switch Delhi or Go Electric campaign like this. Same as Swachh Bharat, because in as electric vehicle market, it is in nascent stage. So the people should aware about whether the good companies, good product is available in the market, which can easily replace the IC engine.
Okay.
So the campaigning for the awareness about the electric vehicle is a very important part. Of course, government is doing that. Even recently, we have seen the Delhi government initiative to continuous commitment towards to make the Delhi the EV capital.
Yes.
So I think other metro cities also, the other state also take this as an oath that we have to do something for the society, and they will also make at least starting the one city of their state to make the EV city, so that it will boost the overall EV electrification of the automobile industry. Also, it will reduce the pollution, and also it will enhance the Atmanirbhar Bharat, so that the people will be self-reliant and they will confident what they are producing, it is producing, and what they are buying for the society, for the next generation.
Right.
So I think these are the things which we can do as a all together as a society. We can have a more awareness program for that, and we have to do more electrification of the automobile industry.
Okay, Abhi Singh Marwa, last word to you.
I think we have urged the government, there are 3 points that the television industry needs immediately, because a lot of the prices have really increased, and they are about spike of 300%. Firstly is PLI. Government has announced PLI for consumer durable and automobile, but they have not included LED televisions right now. I think this will, by adding TVs, government last year has banned CDUs, and I think government needs to include television in the PLI scheme just to be competitive in global stage as well. The next big point is GST. I think the government is trying to have 2 or 3 GST slab above 32 inches. The GST slab for LED TV is 28%, which is highest for any developing or developed nation. So government needs to reduce by 18 or 15% whatever the introduction that they will be doing. And as you know, that television is not a luxury product anymore. It's a daily mass product, so it has to be under 18%. And the third is the custom duty. Last year, again, government has increased custom duty by 5% on open cell panel. As you know, that because of the raw material prices, I think government should again take back custom duty, because demand for television in 2021 is decreasing, as there's a lot of price increase on monthly basis.
Okay, well, let's leave it at that. My thanks to all of you for joining us with your opinions and perspectives on your sectors and, of course, the Indian economy as a whole. Thank you for joining us on this edition of this special panel. On that note,